We now commence session 3 on the topic Listen to Your Body by Ms. Geeta Krishnaraj. Ms. Geeta is the CEO of Ms. Geeta Krishnaraj is the CEO of Maverick Fitness Studio. She's also the creative and financial director of the Maverick Fitness Studios. She continues to motivate and guide people on the most essential aspect of their life, which is health, fitness, and work-life balance. Ms. Geeta Krishnaraj is a very close associate of Madras Management Association. In fact, very recently, she has done a number of lectures in the MMA Forum in management educational institutions. In fact, in Pondicherry University and Salem, wherein she did on the topic Educated Exercises, which was attended by over 2,000 students. In fact, she's got a standing ovation as the students came to know how important the aspect of keeping their health fit and trim is very important both for their career and personal life.
A very happy morning to one and all.
Happy morning.
Not happy for the rest of you? A very good morning, a very happy morning. I'd like to first start by thanking MMA for having me here. I thank each one of you who are present here to spend these precious moments from your life with me. I thank Sea Change Consulting for the efforts they've put in to ensure that this is a grand success. And I thank all those who have logged in to watch this webcast. The Art of Listening to Your Body is a whole day workshop from Maverick Fitness Studios. And it gives me immense pleasure to share a small trailer, a preview of that with all of you. As the Vice Chancellor was telling, if you want to be able managers, I think the first prerequisite is that you need to be a good manager personally, in your personal time, in relation to your personal experiences, in everything that you do. What better coach to tell you how to be a good manager than your own body? Have you ever stopped to wonder, from a drop of protoplasm, this entire body has come forward to manage things so effectively, so efficiently? It never asks you. Just imagine, as you're sitting here, heart is going lap dap lap dap adikitama lap dap adikitama. Does it keep asking you? No. Your kidneys don't ask. I've been always using waste. Time for me to change job. Give me something better. Does it ask? Every morsel of food you eat gets converted into energy for use by your body. Does your body say, no, I can't do this? No, from the time you're born, every cell in your body is striving to keep you alive and striving in cognizance with the rest of the body, trying to ensure that you as a human being get the best out of life. With these few words of introduction of what this subject, what this topic is going to be for the next half an hour, let me proceed. Can I have the audio, please? We have recently come across several instances where people are opting for organ transplant. I'm not here to discuss about organ transplant or the ethics of it or the modalities of it. I'm here to just give you a few certain basic facts. Mother Nature has provided in such a way that when worms eat a plant, it is Mother Nature's way of saying that it's time for recycling. Things are not okay. When anything in your body is not functioning right, not functioning the way it was meant to function, it is a red flag, an SOS sent from your body saying, hello, pay attention, something is not okay. It's time you start taking care. Recently, I read a story about how a young boy needed an organ transplant, and luckily for him, he managed to get one. But within a few months, he had this enormous craving for a specific chicken dish. He had never had meat before. He was a vegetarian. And he had this craving for a chicken dish. And also felt the compulsion to ride a motorbike. Several research students who were working on organ transplant happened to interview him. And when he said that everything is fine, my organs are perfect, they have matched, and my body has accepted it. But you know, something really crazy, I don't know why for the last few weeks I have this urge to have this particular variety of chicken, and I'm tempted to ride a bike. So the research students decided to go and check out with the donor family. It was a post-mortem donation, so the man wasn't alive. But they went and checked with the donor family and asked them, can you tell us something about the person who has donated this organ? And when they inquired, they found out that yes, the donor had a particular liking for that specific chicken dish, and he literally lived on his motorbike. We all think that memory is stored in our brain alone. We think that everything comes from this little bit of our human body. But the truth is, every cell inside you has a memory. Every cell inside you is alive. Every cell inside you can be programmed. We are a composite of everything that this universe can offer. We are the microcosm, is supposed to be a reflection of the macrocosm. Everything that is there in the universe is part of you and me. When every cell in your body is striving to keep you alive, they are doing that by working with each other. So there are times when one part of your body takes precedence over the other. There are what we call fundamental homeostatic controls that take charge of your body. Every cell is embedded with an intelligence in it. That is why a small drop of protoplasm is capable of becoming a whole grown human body. Why this cell chose to be your eyes and why this cell chose to be your fingernail is not in our control. There is an intelligence embedded within every living cell, and we are made up of 100 trillion cells. If every cell has an intelligence, it is also true that every cell is talking to you. Every nanosecond, it is trying to tell you something or the other. The body has a very beautiful fundamental principle called the principle of self-healing. You know, sixth standard, we all learn, in order to stay alive, what all do you need? What do you need to stay alive? Water, food, air, sunlight. We normally talk about these four things. We say we need sunlight, we need oxygen, we need food, and we need air. But imagine there's a person who's dead here and I give him air, water, food and sunlight. Will he come back alive? No. I have the best of medicines available and I force it through his throat. Will he come back alive? No, the medicine is incapable of healing you. Your body